In this video, we will learn how to place a gingival retraction card. Gingival retraction card is usually used for a retraction of the soft tissue surround gingivotooth structure, especially before taking the impression for restoration, indirect restoration like your crown, your veneers, to expose the cervical margins, and especially if these margins are subgingival. So we need to expose them to take the impression of these margins. So there are different types of these gingival cards are available according thickness. There are three types of the cards: 000 and 1. 1 is mostly thick one, and 00 is thin one. So the it depend upon the biotypes of the gums. The biotypes of the gums thickness. If it is a thin biotype, the thin retraction card is selected, and if it is the thick biotype, then the thick number one retraction card is used. Other types of the gingival retraction cards are impregnated with hemostatic agents like aluminum chloride, like your epinephrine, or simply the local anesthetic solution can be used, which also contain the epinephrine. These hemostatic agents used to stop the gingival bleeding. So it has a double function: to mechanically retract the gingiva and also arrest the bleeding. So it's a chemico-mechanical both. The other type is the non-impregnated, and it simply mechanically retract the gingiva. Sometimes we can use it for restoration of class 5 lesions, but class 5 lesion retraction of the gums could maybe properly you can do it with using the rubber dam clamp, like 212 clamp, or commonly the butterfly clamp, or surgically you can expose the margins by giving mini flaps. But in this case, and in this video, is a class 5 lesion restoration. Really, retraction is done with this gingival retraction card. So here it is. You can see here a class 5 lesion. It's having a more thick biotype. A retraction card is used to retract the gums, and this is the ball-ended periodontal probe, which is used to place the retraction card. And mostly the plastic instrument can be used, but that spoon excavator even can be used, but this periodontal ball ended periodontal probe is better one, especially if it is thin biotype.